The horrific murders of Hannah Clarke and her three children shone a spotlight on controlling behaviour in domestic violence relationships. 1 year after their deaths, the Queensland Government has moved to criminalise coercive control, with an independent group set up to help shape the new laws. Here's state political reporter Rachel Rieger.
This young mother, who we'll call Claire, suffered years of domestic violence inflicted by her then-husband. He controlled her finances, what she wore, who she saw, and tracked her every move.
It's horrible mentally to go through. Went through things like being told what clothes I could wear. I was specifically told what underwear he wanted me to wear.
It's this pattern of behaviour called coercive control that the Queensland Government is looking to make a crime.
It's a form of oppression, and it ends up instilling fear in the person that is subjected to it.
Justice Margaret McMurdo will chair an independent task force of experts who will help decide how best to legislate against the behaviour. Their report to be complete by October.
We will consult with legal experts, domestic and family violence, service providers, women with lived experience.
It comes 1 year after the deaths of Hannah Clarke and her three children, who were murdered on the morning school run by her estranged husband in Brisbane. Her parents have been campaigning for coercive control to be a crime after she suffered years of the abuse. The opposition supports robust consultation but wants to see laws introduced much sooner.
Every day that passes, another woman or child is at risk due to the lack of legislation right now.
I hope to have a bill in the Parliament early next year.
The only other state in Australia that has specific laws against coercive control is Tasmania, which has criminalised behaviour like emotional and financial abuse. Queensland's plan will go much further and include matters like cyberstalking, intimidation, and isolating victims from loved ones.
While other states are yet to implement any similar moves, it's hoped the incoming reforms in Queensland will raise community awareness.
And it's not just me or these women now, it's our women, our daughters in the future.
Rachel Rieger, ABC News, Brisbane.